about an enchanting night scenery. We are here at Taoyuan Park, that is well known for being home to one of China's four famous historical pavilions, the Taoyuan Pavilion. Scholars and poets used to spend time here during the Qing Dynasty, and inspired by the beauty of the moon, they would compose and recite their literary works. Therefore, we couldn't have chosen a better spot to appreciate Tang poet Li Bai's classical poem Thoughts on a Tranquil Night. The poem is one of the first classical Tang poems Chinese primary students have to learn by heart. Dating back thousands of years, it has not lost any of its timeliness. Let's read the poem together.
静夜思, 李白, 床见明月光, 疑是堤上霜, 举头望明月, 低头思故乡.
In this environment, the poem leaves me in a wistful mood. Li Bai was a great artist for conveying such strong emotion with so few words. Let's approach the deeper meaning of the poem line by line. Before my bed, a pool of light. The first line tells us many things. First, the narrator is inside his room, sitting on a bed rather than lying down, or else he couldn't have seen what was happening on the floor. Could it be evening or late at night?
Something keeps the narrator from sleeping. Wide awake and eyes wide open, he realizes that light is entering his dark room, probably from a small window, forming a pool in front of the bed.
Can it be hoarfrost on the ground?
Either the narrator of the poem is asking a rhetorical question, comparing the pool of light with a frosty landscape, or the narrator indeed believed for a second that he had seen frost on the floor, and maybe frost reminds him of the frost-covered fields from his childhood memories. Either way, the narrator is contemplating. Looking up, I find the moon bright. The narrator now realizes that the source of the pool of light in front of his bed is the moon itself. It must have been a clear night with the moon shining powerfully. This is usually the case on particularly dark nights during full moon, and often in October, when we observe the most entrancing and biggest moon due to its position to the sun and the earth. Bowing, in homesickness I'm drowned. In the last line, we discover the source of the narrator's contemplation and sleeplessness, homesickness. But how does the moon cause that feeling of longing for home and the loved ones? In China, the round shape of the moon stands for union and family reunion. This is why dining tables in China are usually round, meaning that all members of the family are gathered together in a perfect circle. The narrator can't bear the sight of the round moon any longer. That reminds him of the people and places he is separated from. In sadness, head bowing, the narrator is overwhelmed by grief and longing. Li Bai really touched on a universal theme with his poem that's relevant to many people across the globe. I feel deeply touched by his words. As a Swiss living in Beijing, not a day goes by where I don't miss the lush hills of my hometown. Like in the poem, when all falls quiet at night, the bittersweet feeling of loneliness and missing home creeps in. I suddenly realize that I'm far from the people I love. What's the moon and frost for Li Bai might be a familiar song on the radio for me, or the scent of freshly roasted chestnuts. Do you get homesick at times? Let's admire the poem one last time.
床见明月光，疑是堤上霜。举头望明月，低头思故乡.
The next time you're thinking of your faraway home on a cold, quiet night, find comfort in the bright round moon and Li Bai's compassionate poem. You'll know that people around the world feel the same as they're gazing at the same moon above.